Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 3.2, Problem 3. This is Section 3.2, Problem number 3. It says, consider the sample 26, 32, 20, 22. Find the range, find the variance, and find the standard deviation. So the range is simply the largest data value, which for this problem is 32, minus the smallest data value, which will be 20. So if I do 32 minus 20, that gives me a range of 12. So next, the variance. To find the variance, we use a four-step process. Step one is find the mean and label it x bar. So we'll have x bar equals 26 plus 32 plus 20 plus 22 divided by 4 because I have 4 data values. So if I get a total on top, 26 and 32 is 58, 58 and 20 is 78, 78 plus 22 is 100, actually. So 100, I'm going to divide that by 4. The answer I get is 25. So that's the mean. Step one is find the mean, label it x bar, and that's what we've done. Step two is fill out the chart. The chart has three columns. The first column is x, the middle column is x minus x bar, and the last column is x minus x bar in parentheses to the second power. So the x column, you simply fill in with the data that's given to you in the problem. So for this problem, that would be 26, 32, 20, and 22. And then for the next column, for every value of x, you subtract off x bar, which for our problem here is 25. So in the top row, x minus x bar will be 26 minus 25, which is positive 1. And the next row down, x is 32, so x minus x bar is 32 minus 25, which will be positive 7. Then in the next row down, x is 20, so x minus x bar is 20 minus 25, which would be negative 5. And finally in the bottom row, x minus x bar will be 22 minus 25, which is negative 3. Now, as an optional thing you can do at this point is see if the middle column has a total of 0. That's a good check. If you don't have 0 as a total of your middle column, you made a mistake somewhere. So if I combine, I have two positive values, 1 and 7 for positive 8, two negative values, negative 5 and negative 3 for negative 8, and if I add those up, I do get a total of 0, which is a good sign. So now the last column, I will take my answers for x minus x bar and raise them all to the second power. So in the top row, x minus x bar is 1. I'll do 1 second power. 1 times 1 is 1. In the next row down, x minus x bar was 7, so I'll do 7 second power. 7 times 7 is 49. In the next row down, x minus x bar was minus 5, so I'll have minus 5 second power. Minus 5 times minus 5 is positive 25. Remember, the negatives will cancel. And finally, in the bottom row, x minus x bar was negative 3. So negative 3 to the second power, negative 3 times negative 3 is positive 9. So that's step 2. Step 2 is fill in the chart, and we fill in the chart. There it is. Step 3, get a total of the last column. So total up, 1 and 49 is 50, 50 and 25 is 75, 75 plus 9 is 84. And then finally step 4, the last step. Take your total from step 3, divide by n minus 1 for a sample, divide by n for a population. So this is a sample, the problem says sample. So I'll take 84, my total from step 3, divide it by n minus 1. N is 4 because I have 4 data values, 1, 2, 3, 4. So n minus 1 is 4 minus 1, and that'll be 84 divided by 3. So 84 divided by 3 is 28. So that makes the variance 28. And if you want to use the symbol, since this is a sample, the symbol for variance is s to the second power. They'd say s squared. And then the standard deviation, which is just s, is the square root of whatever the variance is. So this is something you'd probably want to use a calculator for. It's going to fill the nth decimals within some type of sensible round off. Let's say two places after the decimal. You'd get 5.29 for your answer for standard deviation.